to my channel, and this involves 3-in-1 combination machining.
As you can see, there are many variants of this machine, all painted different colours and provided by many suppliers throughout the world. This actually means there are thousands of these machines out there that people are using. My choice was Chester Centurion simply because I reside in the UK. I can contact the supplier if anything goes wrong with the unit, and I can also get spares easy. Why did I pick a 3-in-1 combination machine? Simply because I am restricted on space. I would dearly love a Bridgeport mill and a super fantastic lathe, but unfortunately I just cannot fit them in this area. Therefore, I had to go with a compact and versatile machine that I could use. Other features were the distance between centres. When would I actually put a 0.5 metre piece of steel in for turning? Not very often, to say this is a hobbyist machine. The good function about this machine is it can turn threads in both metric and imperial. This is achieved by changing the gear ratios at the side of the machine. Ostensibly, all the dials are set up for the machine to work in metric, down to 0.01 millimetre tolerance. Regarding the mill and drill press, the speeds vary from 3000 RPM down to 125. This is achieved by modifying the pulley arrangement. And once again, the tolerances of the drill press and mill are down to 0.01 millimetre. Before using the machine, it's strongly recommended that you adjust the gibs on the cross slide. I have had many hours invested in pieces of equipment, then only to ruin them because I've not had this set up correctly. I've highlighted them here in yellow, and as you can see, I've modified the original gib locks so these have locking nuts on, because they tend to work loose over time. Other adjustments to be made are on the apron as it traverses on the bed. It took me quite some time to find out how to adjust these, as the manufacturer had put grub screws in that went 75mm inside the apron. They were so difficult to adjust. So what I did, I stripped them out, put some 8mm threaded bar in with lock nuts. I've highlighted them here in yellow, and I do recommend that you adjust these before you start machining. Finally, to tighten the whole assembly up, you've got to adjust the top slide gibs. I've highlighted them here in yellow. These will be modified at a later date when I have time. And finally, for the hack of the day, this is where I stole my drill press and chuck key. Simply done, get hold of a welder's 45 degree magnet, stick it on the machine, and keep your keys in a safe location.